U.S. Army super vaccine versus all COVID-19 variants. Omicron here and the COVID vaccine fourth dose over there, except the latter is being pushed back by EMA and the WHO. But if there's a super vaccine, we can better deal with this variant once and for all. Perhaps, the U.S. Army's version of this vaccine could be the one we're looking for. It's dubbed SpFN and is showing promise against all COVID-19 variants. Having a super vaccine around is a good thing. We can finally breathe fresh air if it works across all variants, past, current, or future. So, what do we know about these SpFN vaccine? First and foremost, the experimental vaccine just wrapped its phase 1 clinical trial. However, it would still need to succeed phase 2 and 3 before it could get emergency use authorization. Next, the vaccine has been developed by scientists at Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. According to CNET, this product isn't limited to the COVID-19 virus. The people behind it want to adapt it for all coronaviruses to prevent future coronavirus pandemics. So how does it work? The SpFN, short for the Spike Ferritin Nanoparticle COVID-19 vaccine, uses a different approach compared to Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson. Instead of using mRNA or a vector to induce an immune response, the SpFN uses a harmless part of the coronavirus to get the same result. On top of that, the design allows the vaccine to be stored more flexibly than Pfizer or Moderna vaccines. At room temperatures, it can last for 1 month. If stored in temperatures between 36 and 46 degrees Fahrenheit, it can last for up to 6 months. This means the vaccine isn't so sensitive to temperatures during transport. For administration, the SpFN is tested for 2 shots with an interval of 28 days, and with the 3rd shot 6 months later. And now for the biggest question, does it work against Omicron? It is now being tested against this variant, and right now, results are promising. Since current vaccines like Pfizer, Moderna, and J&J target a specific part of SARS-CoV-2, mutations made them less effective in many scenarios. But the SpFN is tailored as pan-coronavirus by targeting a common part across coronaviruses to get around mutations. Things that look like viruses but don't cause disease will generate a much more potent, much more broad, much more durable response, said Dr. Kevan Mojarrad, co-inventor of SpFN. Despite the promising start, the vaccine still has a long way to go. It must not fail both phase 2 and 3 trials or the whole project will be scrapped or restarted. What's your take on this super vaccine? Do you believe that the US Army has truly made a pan-coronavirus vaccine? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.